In this tutorial, we're going to discuss about valves. Pressure valve, should I say? What is a pressure valve? Pressure valve is used on a geyser to regulate the pressure inside the geyser. If we had no pressure valve and the pressure went up in the neighborhood, we would burst the geyser. So simple terms, a valve is basically used to control the pressure to a geyser. In front of me, we have a few examples. This is a master flow valve, and this is the quick flow valve. These are the most expensive valves you get. These valves are rated 400 kPa. As you can see, it has a red sticker. A lot of the old houses have this valve in them, and also this valve called the master flow and the quick flow. Again, we know it's 400 kPa, but these valves are sort of getting done away with, and these are the new valves that are coming into place. These are called a quick watt multi-flow valve. Multi-flow because it has a tap, meaning that you will close the water if you need to work on the geyser. But if you need to change the valve, you cannot close the water. You would have to close the mains to replace this valve because it will burst. Okay, we can see this is a multi 600 kPa because again, it's got a green tag. Green is always 600 kPa. And also on here, you have the little relief valve. So what happens is when you want to clean the valve out, all that you do is you give that a twist and that will clean the valve. And we can see we have another quick watt valve, exactly the same rating, 600 kPa. And this is called a mono valve. Mono meaning there is no tap to close the water. So this valve has no tap. Okay, these valves are quite expensive. They're about $1,050. Then you have the cheaper valve called the advanced valve. This is a 400 kPa valve. This is also a multi-valve because it has a tap to close the water. This is one of the cheaper valves, much more cheaper than a quick watt valve. And once this valve leaks, it's better just to replace the entire valve. So again, we can see these valves are installed with Konex, so there's no soldering. So you put your pipe in there, you tighten the nut, as we learned earlier on. And also these valves must always have an overflow that goes out to the building, because if this will leak 3 to 5 liters of water a day, which can happen, you don't want this to mess on your ceiling. So the right way is to put an overflow pipe outside. If you have low pressure on your hot water side, or even on your cold water side, so meaning if the valve comes in from the house's supply and then goes to the geyser, you have low water pressure on your cold water as well as on your hot water, then what you could do is inside this valve here, you could loosen this cartridge here, obviously closing the water, loosen the cartridge, clean the filter here, inside here as a filter, you could clean the filter out, put it back, make sure you don't cross thread the valve, and open the water and your problem should be resolved. So that's all about pressure valves. I'm going to teach you guys exactly how to install them and what to do before you install them. I'll see you in the next tutorial.